हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। एज यू नो आई हैव स्टार्टेड मेकिंग वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर यू ऑन केमिकल काइनेटिक्स। दिस इज माय सेकंड वीडियो लेक्चर फॉर यू ऑन केमिकल काइनेटिक्स। आई थिंक आफ्टर वाचिंग दिस वीडियो लेक्चर यू विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड नंबर वन रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन, टाइप ऑफ रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन दैट इज एवरेज रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन एंड instantaneous rate of reaction, rate in terms of pressure, relation between rate of reaction and products, active mass, law of mass action and rate law, and the unit of rate constant K and unit of K in different order of reaction. Let us start the second video lecture. What is rate of reaction? As you know, rate of reaction, this is equal to plus minus delta C by delta T, where delta C is the change in concentration of reactants or products. And delta T, change in time, or time taken for change in concentration, concentration. Here, plus sign represents concentration of product increases and minus sign indicates concentration of reactant decreases with increase of time t. Now, I would like to discuss type of reactions. This is average rate of reaction. Rate of reaction. This is equal to R average, and this is equal to delta C by delta T. For the concentration versus time graph, here is the x-axis and this is y-axis. Along the x-axis we take time and along the y-axis we take concentration. As we know, either time increases, concentration of reactant decreases. So regarding the concentration of reactant, the concentration versus time graph will appear like this. Concentration of reactants. This is time C2 and this is time T1. This is C1 and this is time T1. This is time T1, this is time T2. And corresponding time T2, this is the concentration of the reactant. This is C2. So rate of friction R average is equal to delta C by delta T, and this will be equal to, where delta C is change in concentration of reactant, initial concentration, that is at the time T1 concentration of reactant is C1, and at the time T2 concentration of reactant is C2. So change in concentration is equal to C2 minus C1 by T2 minus T1. This is the average rate of reaction. For the graph for products, as you know, if the time increases, concentration of product increases. So the graph appears like this. X-axis, this is y-axis, and now we take time along x-axis, and this is concentration along y-axis. At the time T2, the concentration of the reactant is this is C2. And at time T1, concentration of the product is C1. So rate of reaction R average, here in this case rate of reaction will be R average is equal to change in concentration of the product. What is the concentration of the product in time T1? C1, and at time T2 it is C2. So change in concentration will be C2 minus C1 by T2 minus T1, and this is equal to delta C by delta T, and this is the average rate of friction. What is instantaneous rate of friction? Second is instantaneous rate of friction. Instantaneous rate of reaction. Instantaneous rate of reaction. Instantaneous is equal to delta C by delta T is equal to limit delta T tends to 0 delta C by delta T, and this will lead to minus dc by dt. Here negative sign shows that concentration of reactant decreases with increase of time T, and concentration of product, and this will be equal to plus dc by dt. plus dc by dt. Here plus sign shows that concentration of product increases with increased time t. Here negative sign indicates concentration of reactant decreases with increase of time t, and here positive sign shows that concentration of product increases with increase of time t. Now, if the graph is represented simultaneously for reactant and product, then the graph may be represented as follows.